Hello, this is Brecht Billet and welcome to my new episode of my Simplified Courses YouTube channel. In the previous episode, we have created a simple template-driven forms with a unidirectional data flow with signals, and today we're gonna step it up a notch. We're gonna create a more complex form, we're gonna create some conditional logic with Angular view models. Let's have a look at our form. We can see that we have the first name and the last name that we saw before as well, but now we have the age and the emergency contact. We want to disable the emergency contact when the person is of legal age, otherwise we want to enable it. We also have a gender and a gender other. Only when the value of the gender is set to other, this field should be available. It should be shown, but it should also be available in the form. Otherwise, it should just be removed. We also have a billing address and a shipping address. This shipping address should only be shown when this checkbox is being set to true. So also, we want Angular to remove it from the DOM, but also remove it from the reactive form it created behind the scenes and re-edit when it's necessary. And here we can see that we have our form value that we saw in the previous video, and we populate it over here. So we have a completely unidirectional data flow. This is a working form. Our ng models do not use the banana in a box syntax. They just use the square brackets. They use our signal with the property they need. Now the first effect that we're going to do is we're going to create a view model. The view model is a computed signal. And we will expose this view model to our template through a getter. So let's refactor our template. Let's replace the form value with VM form value. And let's check if the form still works. Yes, it seems so. So the first thing that we want to do is we want to disable this emergency contact number when the person is of legal age. So let's add a property to our view model. And let's call it emergency contact disabled. And we want to disable it whether the age is zero or age is bigger than 17. Right now we can use the disabled input to disable this when the emergency contact should be disabled. So when it's 0, it's disabled. When it's 5, I can enter in here. When it's 18, it's disabled again. The next thing that we want to do is we want to show the other gender, but only when the value of the gender is set to other. We're going to use an ngif directive for that, but first of all, let's update our view model. Let's add a property called show other gender form value when the gender is set to other. In our template right now, we see here that we can use the ngif VM show other gender, and we can see that the field is being removed here. If I select male or female, it's not shown. With other, it will be shown, as you can see here. If we're going to click on female, for instance, you will see that the field will be removed, but it will also be removed from a reactive form or template driven form creates a reactive form, remember, behind the scenes. The fact that Angular is conditionally automatically removing and re-adding controls for us is very nice because we don't have to manually do that anymore. But Angular can also do that for form groups. As we said before, we have two different addresses. We have the shipping address and the billing address. If the shipping address is different than the billing address, both form groups should be shown. We want Angular to remove the form group for us, but also remove it for the form entirely, because it might have validations on it. We could just access the properties in the template like this. ngif vm form value addresses shipping address different from billing address. This seems to work. It's cleaner if we add it to our view model. Now we have a nice and clean property that we can access in our template, and we don't have any logic in our template anymore. Let's see if this works. Right now we can see we have the street and everything is being filled in. We see that it's being removed automatically for us. Our entire template-driven form logic lives here. We have 4 lines of code, but we have a tremendous amount of functionality that we have just created. We have no boilerplate and we have a clean template. I hope you loved this episode. If you like it, please subscribe. Have a great day. I'm also creating a template-driven forms online course. It's not ready yet, but it should be soon. If you're interested, you can click the link below and I'll gladly give you a 10% discount. Cheers.